The scale of the rift between health officials and the government has been exposed in a fiery letter that slams claims of financial mismanagement. One News has obtained the letter from Te Whatu Ora's former chair. It suggests the finance minister was misled by her treasury officials about the nature of a crucial meeting. Senior political reporter Benedict Collins has this exclusive report.
According to the government, Health New Zealand's board was incompetent and had to be sacked.
And I have a copy of a letter that I wrote to the Minister of Health on the 19th of March, where we were starting to get information through that there were real financial problems at Health New Zealand.
Officials thought those in charge of the agency seemed oblivious to the problems.
Treasury officials met with the Board of Health New Zealand on 23 February 2024 and report. The board did not seem across the detail of this issue.
But what the finance minister didn't tell us is that the Board of Health New Zealand immediately wrote back, disputing what they said were her unfair allegations.
The letter acknowledged that Health New Zealand was under financial pressure, but said this came from Holidays Act changes and pay equity settlements, as opposed to Te Whatu Ora not managing its costs. The board said it would have happily discussed these financial pressures with officials, but the issue simply never came up at the meeting.
It looks like they're blaming the board for information they didn't even ask for.
The health minister, though, convinced the government's right.
The point she was making was that there wasn't a sense that the board was sharing information with Treasury was the point that she was making in that letter.
Yeah, but Te Whatu Ora wrote back to you and said that Treasury never raised those issues around the details of their finances with them at that meeting.
It's probably a discussion to have with Treasury, but there was that general sense that it was a challenge getting information from Health New Zealand.
It really refutes the Minister of Finance and the Minister of Health's version of events, and it suggests the board is being blamed for a mess of the government's own making.
The release of the letter comes as a former Te Whatu Ora board member, Dr. Curtis Walker, accused the government of spreading disinformation.
Is Dr. Curtis Walker correct when he says, as the political pressure has come on this government, they have been increasingly desperate in their casting about of misinformation?
Mr. Speaker, Dr. Walker is correct when he said he first became made aware of the deteriorating financial position at Health New Zealand in March.
Yet Dr. Walker also said it was because Health New Zealand had overspent on nurses and not being middle manager heavy, as the government maintains. Benedict Collins, One News.